Sometimes, installing Windows from DVD media becomes a nightmare when you found that the media is corrupted, or DVD drive is not accessing the media properly. In another case, you need to install Windows on a notebook or laptop which doesn't have DVD drive. At that time, you think of having a bootable USB flash drive, which can easily save you from all these hassles. In this video, you will learn that how easily you can create a bootable USB flash drive using a few commands. Before we begin, let's take a look what you need first. A computer with Windows operating system, a USB drive, a minimum of 4 GB in size, and Windows 8 DVD installation disk, or Windows 8 ISO image. Let's get started. Plug in your USB drive into USB port. Insert your Windows 8 installation media, or mount an ISO image, if you have one. Now, you need to run command prompt with administrative privilege. To do this, click Start button, type CMD in search box, right-click on command prompt, and then click Run as administrator. Once you are on command prompt, type DISKPART and press Enter. Windows will load the DISKPART application, and you can notice that prompt sign now has changed to DISKPART. First, we need to check which drives are currently connected and can be used with DISKPART. To do this, type list space disk and press Enter key. DISKPART will show you all the available drives. Note that DISKPART will display all the connected drives, either they are hard disk drives or removable devices. Be sure to perform the next step carefully, because to create a bootable USB drive, you will perform format and clean command on a selected disk. Make sure to choose the right disk. As the list is showing two drives, our USB flash drive is on number 2, which we can identify from the size of the disk. So, our next command we'll use to select the disk on which we will perform some tasks to make it bootable. Type select space disk space and then the disk number, which is in our case is number 2, and then press Enter key. A message will appear, notifying you about which disk is being selected. Now, we need to remove the previous partition table from the disk. To do this, type clean, and press Enter key. If any error occurs, then you can run the clean command again. A message will appear, indicating that the disk has been successfully cleaned up. Now, we need to create a partition on the disk. Type create space partition space primary and press Enter key. After the successful creation of primary partition, select the partition by typing select space partition space 1. As it is a new partition, you need to format it with a file system, so you may able to use it. Type format space fs equals ntfs space quick. You must use the quick switch with the format command, else it may take longer to format the disk. Once it is formatted, type active to make the current primary partition as active partition, and then type assign and press Enter key to assign a drive letter to the new partition. Type exit to quit from DISKPART utility, but do not close the command prompt yet. Open Windows Explorer and note down the drive letters of both media, like we now currently have drive G as DVD media, drive K as USB media. Go back to the command prompt, and the last step is to create a BOOTSECT file on the USB drive, which can be done through BOOTSECT command, and that is available on your Windows 8 DVD media. Now, you need to move to the boot directory to run BOOTSECT command, which is available on your Windows 8 DVD. To do this, type G colon, which is the drive letter of our DVD media, and press Enter key. Here, type cd space boot, and press enter key. Now, type bootsect space, slash nt60 space, k colon, and press enter key. Drive K is the letter that Windows assigned to our USB drive. Type exit and press enter key to close the command prompt. Open your DVD drive, select all the files, and send them, or copy them to your USB media. That is all. You are done creating a new bootable USB flash drive. What you need to do now is to change the boot order within from BIOS, to tell your PC to boot from USB flash drive first. Hope you may have enjoyed this video. Keep liking, sharing, and commenting on our videos, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and have a good day.